Chris here with an affordable full HD projector. I know I've been covering a lot of very expensive ultra short throws, so this is something here to balance it out a bit. And for the price point, it does offer a lot. It's from emotn, it's called the N1, and it is Netflix certified, as this video is titled. That means, just out of the box, it runs Netflix in full HD. Amazon Prime Video is installed, there is an app store, and it has a Linux OS, so it doesn't run Android TV. But in a way, it is a good thing because the performance of that UI is very quick and snappy. It has two built-in speakers. They are 5 watts each. I'll give you a sample of how they sound, a sample of the fan noise in this video. I'll also demonstrate the autofocus and auto keystone correction, which is plus or minus 20 degrees in action. So it's very easy for you to just move this about and it will adjust that image straight away, so you don't have to waste time fixing the keystone and then correcting that focus. If you do move your projectors around a lot, it is very handy. And I'll let you know what the image quality is like and all the pros and the cons here of the emotn N1. Now included along with the N1, you will find a support card. So there's various different contacts there for emotn. You've got the user manual, then our remote here. It does not come with the batteries, but it's a standard Android TV layout here for the remote. So dedicated Netflix button, Amazon Prime Video, YouTube. You've got the menu, the home, focus there. Our power supply, so this is 120 watts, and the power cable. So the display tech here that it does use is LCD, and the light source is LED. The lifespan of it is 30,000 hours, which is excellent. And it's a sealed unit, this, so no dust should get inside. Now we are looking at a throw ratio of 1.25 to 1. The image size can go anywhere from 60 inches to 120. And you'll see there that it does have a sensor. So it's got a time of flight sensor. This is it. Laser autofocus, auto keystone correction, which is plus or minus 20 degrees, and you've got manual keystone correction with it. So it is 500 ANSI lumens, the maximum brightness. It does support HDR10 and HLG. Along the back of it, there is more ventilation. There's the fan in here, and we have two speakers. So they're 5 watts each, and these are Dolby digital speakers. And again, I'll give you a sample of that later on. Up here at the top, we've got line out 3.5 millimeter, LAN, HDMI input, and USB 2.0 if you wanted to run some external files, and of course DC in for powering it. Now the power consumption of this unit is typically around 110 watts. Left and right, there are no ports or anything. Now the build of this, the outside of it is plastic. It's well done and it's good quality everything here. It does not feel or look cheap at all. Up the top, a power button with status LED. Finally, the underside, it does have these 4 solid rubber feet that it will sit on. There is a kickstand too, so good to see that they have incorporated and built this into it, so we don't have to worry about propping it up on anything else. And there is this, a tripod mounting point. So yes, you could mount this on a ceiling mount, have it upside down, and then just flip the image around. Now for my setup, I have the emotn N1 about 180 centimeters away from a high quality ALR screen, and I'm currently projecting at an estimated 70 inches is what I'll be showing you throughout this video. So like some of the other projectors I have reviewed, this is running Linux and not Android TV. Android TV, yes, is based off Linux, but this is a lot more lightweight here, and you've got a gigabyte of RAM and 8 gigabytes of storage, but that is all it does need, and it is pretty quick. It's very fast because it's so cut down and so lightweight compared to Android TV. I do happen to like it. So here we have screencast, home share, Bluetooth speaker, so you can get the N1 to act as a speaker. Tiki Live, this is a cartoon network channel there. You got open browser, YouTube Kids, Netflix, Amazon Prime Video are the ones, I think, those three key ones that most people will be using. And the good thing about it is, of course, as I mentioned there at the start, Netflix certified, so it's in 1080p. You don't have to mess about like a lot of those other brands that don't have the certification. You only get it in standard definition, and it does kind of look terrible, not very good. So you got a lot of things in here too in the App Store. So if you wanted some more applications, you can find plenty in here. There are some categories at the top. So I'll just quickly show you that there's kids, you've got music, movies, whatnot, a lot in there too. And a lot of these channels, for example, like France 24, the news one, they have their own application. So they'll be streaming their own channel, so you can use those. And there's a lot of handy bits and pieces in there. So you're not cut short when it comes to applications, but you know, not as complete as Android TV would be with the applications there. So let's jump into some of the settings now and take a look at them. These are all specific to our projector. So you have your picture mode. I've just kept this on standard, but you have custom, and there's a few other presets there, cinema too as well. So custom's where you can go on there and adjust it yourself. I'll talk about a bit about the image quality shortly. Audio, projection. So this is if you were going to be using it, imagine that you've got it mounted to a ceiling mount where here you can go and then invert that image to however you've got your projector set up. Network, so I've connected up already and it does thankfully have 5G support. So this is a lot faster than 2.4G when it comes to our wireless. And yes, there was a firmware update, which I am currently running at the moment. So if I go into version info, you'll see that this is the latest update that I got, which was the OTA. And so I'm on version 1.0.2. So that is great there that they're at least pushing out some updates. Bluetooth, that's pretty self-explanatory. The focus, so you've got autofocus, which does work really well. I'll just demonstrate that now. It's going to go in and out, and you will see it find the focus right there. Then you have manual. If you decide that, oh, I think, you know, that's not quite 100% perfect, then you can go and just adjust that a little bit if you wanted to do so. And it's just up and down with the remote. You save that and you have advanced options here. So you can get it to do it at start or whenever it gets moved, which is probably the best one to leave on too. You can enable that, but it's off by default. Now zoom, this is digital zoom, of course, with this unit. And it's going to degrade the quality a little bit. So try not to zoom if possible. Just bring the projector up closer. Keystone, so you've got manual. You can go along and adjust this yourself. I found that the keystone seems to be pretty good just straight out of the box. You have advanced option, again, to turn this on, that if you move it about a lot, you probably want to enable that, so it will automatically do it. I'll just demonstrate the keystone, so hit auto now, and there we go. It has adjusted it, and probably looks like it's a little bit off now. That's because I'd manually tweaked it myself, so I've just lost that. I'm going to have to redo that myself. So those are the settings in here. The setup is what you go through when you first just start it up anyway. So that's it. There's quite a few options in there. Pretty standard for a projector like this. Lastly, just to show you the input menu, this is all self-explanatory. So we've got the HDMI home and USB. If you're going to plug in an external storage, well, that is where you access it. So I'll go into Netflix now and I'll show you just a little bit of what it is like, how it runs. This is very fast, the menu. You can see when you get into it that it is good. It's just a lot faster than Android TV, I think, because I've not noticed any caching of it loading in those thumbnails, which you sometimes do see on some Android TV boxes or projectors with Android TV built into them. So I will go into an episode of something here just to show you what it is like. So I'll go into Vikings, just so you can see how quick it loads in. Obviously, I can't show you a lot of footage, but look at that. It's just straight into it, straight away. And I can tell that that is definitely not standard definition. That is running at, yes, 1080p. And it does have a Widevine level 1 cert. So that's why it is going to be running there at 1080p. So just get out of this now and we'll take a look at Amazon Prime Video, which is the other major streaming service. I think that most people will be using both of those apps. And Amazon Prime Video, so that did load in very quick, no problems. I don't see any lag with it when I go through the menu, which is great. So it is looking good. Now, just to point out here in the menu with this LCD, well, LED projector, the light source here, that it is looking good. Like, I don't see any of that horrible noise, that grain that I have noticed with some projectors. So the image quality for the price point, I think, is good. I think it is not bad at all. So just go in here to the power of the rings of power, and resume this. You can see it does come up with Dolby Atmos support. This is taking a little bit longer than Netflix for some reason to load in. Okay, and yes, that is looking good. Again, not in standard definition. You can tell because there's just a lot more detail to it. So the blacks here, the image quality, I am very happy with those blacks. The brightness, well, it's that 500 ANSI lumens. Let's take a look at some more sample footage, this time with YouTube. So this is looking good here. I'm happy with the colors. I think for the price point of this projector, the image quality is fairly decent. What I've noticed around the edges, it does dim down a little there. So you're not getting a 100% uniformed 500 ANSI lumens. You'll notice around the edges is a little bit dimmer there. And this is kind of typical with LCD and LED image source here, that is going to be not quite as good as laser. Definitely not going to be able to match what you see with laser. But overall, I mean, it does look very good, I think, for this style of projector and what you're getting here. The image is very good. And here we have a look at a bit of Amsterdam again. So the colors, I think the colors are fine for this. The vibrancy, the contrast is good. The saturation levels, gamma, contrast, yeah. It all seems to check out, I believe, for this style of projector for what you're after. Because it cannot compete with some of those really high quality projectors that I've been covering lately, which are super expensive. We're talking $3,000, $4,000 machines, laser 4K. But for what it is for 1080p, I'm really happy here with the image quality and what I'm seeing. But what happens if I turn on a very bright light? How are those 500 ANSI lumens going to fare now? So that's a very powerful now studio light on. This is approximately about 150 watts. Just aimed straight at my ALR screen. So the ALR screen is helping here with this image quality. Now, I can still make out and see perfectly fine what is on the screen, but yeah, it doesn't look as good, of course. It's not going to look anywhere as good. You can see now the blacks look gray. The image is looking quite washed out. This is typical, so you want to be watching in a dark room. You want to be looking and using this projector, ideally in a completely pitch black room. If you've got a tiny bit of ambient light, that won't be too much of a problem. So if I angle the light away now, you can see how straight away that image quality has improved. It's looking a lot better now, which is good, which you'd expect. And if I turn that light off now completely, there we go. It's now back to normal. Blacks looking, well, a tiny bit gray, but it's not coming through with my recording a little there. That was just the splash screen for YouTube. But now, yeah, the blacks, again, commenting on those, that they are very decent. Well, especially with this ALR screen. So having a look now at the autofocus and auto keystone in action, I've set with the advanced menu tab there to enable them both autofocus and auto keystone with movement. So when I move the projector now, you see to one side, the keystone works straight away. The autofocus is a little slower as it zooms out, then back in and finds the sweet spot, which it has right now. And that is looking very good, apart from the left side, maybe a little bit out the focus there, but you can adjust that and tweak it manually. So do that one more time just to move it to the left now. And there we go, keystone looks very good this time, spot on. And then the focus, that is looking great. So that has now focused, and I probably wouldn't go and adjust that really, because I don't think I could make that any better. Just bring up the screen, it's very easy with the remote. And no, it seems to be about where I would have it anyway. So the keystone and the autofocus is all working really well with the N1. Onto the fan noise now, which for me really is the only con of this particular projector, that the fan noise, it's there, you're going to hear it. It's like a bit of a whining kind of noise. It's not super loud or anything, but it is present. It's certainly not the quietest of the 1080p projectors that I have covered in the channel. So I'll give you a sample of what it sounds like. If you're going to be sitting next to it, you are certainly going to hear the constant RPM, the whining noise that it does make, this fan. And then our speakers that are built into it. So they're about here. There's two of them, 5 watts each. Got good volume to them, a little bit of bass as you'll hear from this. They don't sound amazing, they're not fantastic, but they aren't bad either. I don't think they're bad for built-in speakers. So here's that sample at 100% volume. How about a console gaming? Could you plug in, for example, a PlayStation 5, which I've done just now, and play games with this N1 projector? Let's find out. So the big thing here is going to be the input lag, the latency. I don't know what the response times are with this particular projector, but I would say it would be like standard. It's going to be over about 20 milliseconds or so, maybe even a lot higher than that, even at 1080p. So when I turn to the left and the right here, in fact, that's fine. I'm not having any problems with this at all. Now, I was expecting that maybe the latency here could be that slow that I might have issues with just some casual console gaming like this with Dirt 5 at the moment. But no, I can happily play this. This seems to be all right. So when I'm turning to the left and the right, yep, that is working. That's working just fine. So I think for this kind of style, just casual console gaming, so you can hook up your PlayStation, your Xbox. And if you wanted to game with the emotn in one, well, it's not going to be a problem for that style of gaming. It's not going to have the greatest latency, but it is definitely still playable. As you can see here, I'm having no trouble at all. So I think for the price point, I cannot really complain at all with the image quality. I do think it is good. The contrast, the levels are black. There is no annoying speckle. I don't see any color fringing. The gamma, the contrast checks out for this price point and the style of projector being LCD, LED light source, which they say is good for 30,000 hours. That's a lot. Now it is a sealed unit, so no dust should be getting in there at all. So it's going to be really good for longevity too with it. And as you saw, the auto keystone and autofocus is working really well. The built-in 5-watt speakers, I think they sound fine for being built-in ones. And the UI, Linux, very fast, quick and snappy. You can download other applications, other streaming services. Netflix, Amazon Prime Video is working very well, very quick and in full HD basically straight away. And it does support 5 gigahertz. That is our band there for the wireless, not 2.4 gigahertz, which can be very slow nowadays. So it streams really quick and no problems with it at all. So it's all checking out apart from one thing, and that is the fan noise. It had to be something at this price point. It's a little loud. Now, the sample I gave you, I actually went back and recorded again because when I was gaming for a lot longer than the sample I showed you, it ended up getting even louder because the fan ramped up a bit as the temperatures rose and I heard it even more. So that sample was at the top fan noise. So if you're going to be sitting next to it, you are certainly going to hear the N1. That is really the only thing that this projector I can find with it. The rest of it, I think for the price point, is very good. So you're getting a great deal, I think, with the image quality, what's on offer, and especially having Netflix, Amazon Prime Video already installed and just working straight away. And it's really easy to set them up because if you've got the application or on your phone, you have yourself logged into Netflix or Amazon, you simply need to scan the QR codes and it will log you in and you're up and running. It really is so simple and quick. So there we go. That's the full story of the emotn N1, an affordable Netflix certified full HD projector.